Alrighty, what is up, guys? We're back with some more Play What You Own challenge. I know it's been a bit since we've done it. We're just gonna hop right in here. We're playing some Banjo-Tooie on the N64. It's such a classic game. Love this game so much. Recently, I've just been playing through the game again, and I've been really getting into it, which is awesome because I haven't really played an older game in a while that I've been able to like keep going through. Usually, I just do one session, get as far as I can from the beginning. And then I just stop playing it because it kind of fulfills my need to play the game, I suppose. So it's kind of nice being able to go back and play games, older games, I should say, and still enjoy playing them longer than one session. And you're probably like, "Hey, why didn't you start from the beginning of the game like you do with every other every other game that you've been doing for this challenge?" And I was thinking about it. I was like, I should probably start from the beginning. And then I was just like, yeah, but the first little bit of the game is like all cutscenes, and like the rest is all sorry, no, the first little bit is cutscenes, and the first level of the game is probably one of my least favorite levels in like any Banjo game. Which is actually being pretty generous because Nuts and Bolts exists, which I totally forgot about. So that's being pretty generous. But yeah, I've been really getting into the game again. So I was just like, man, I really want to play the game again. So hopefully, as I'm going through the challenge, stuff like this will happen where I'll be like, man, I really want to play older games, and I'll just be like, "Yep, let's do that." So we have to go switch to Mumbo because, unlike in the first game, Banjo-Tooie, you can switch into Mumbo, and you can still switch to cool critters and objects through Humbawumba, who is the new shaman for this game. Mumbo is still a shaman, but because they made him playable, he obviously can't turn you into things as well. So they were like, we had something good here, and now we need to completely tear that down and make someone new so that Mumbo can be a playable character. Which is okay. The game is great. I love this game. Such a good game. In saying that though, honestly, I would probably say that Kazooie is probably still my favorite game in the series, and I think a lot of that's just nostalgia. So that's probably what it is. There's just a lot of nostalgia for the first game because it's one of those games that came with my N64, which I've talked about dozens of times. I talked about it when I did my Let's Play. I talked about it when I did my Mario 64 Let's Play. I probably talked about it when I did my Ocarina of Time Let's Play. And I'm talking about it now. And basically any other time that I talk about when I got my N64, I talk about the three games I got with it, which were Banjo-Kazooie, Super Mario 64, and Legend of Zelda: Ocarina of Time. And there you go. That's like the fourth time on my channel probably that I've talked about that now. So yeah, this is the reason that we came and hit this conveyor belt, because the rock here that Mumbo put in is now going to just kind of be like, it's just gonna drift down the conveyor there, and it's gonna get crushed in the grinder at the end here, and it's gonna spit out jiggy pieces at us, and we have to go collect all the pieces of the jiggy in order to actually get that jiggy, which I actually thought was a really cool concept. And unfortunately, it's the only time they use it in the game, but at least with this, it kind of makes sense. Like, you grind up the rock to get the jiggy out, but it grinds up the jiggy as well. I always thought that was really clever. So we actually have to come and collect all the pieces of the jiggy, and it actually only plays part of the Jiggy Collection theme, which I actually think is a really neat touch as well. So we get the three, and we get our Jiggy there, and then we're gonna go over near the train station so that we can flip the train station up. So unfortunately, for anyone who has played Banjo-Tooie, we're not gonna be doing any of the Jiggy Wiggy challenges because I was just messing around in the game and I used the cheat code to unlock all the levels. In saying that, we can't actually access all the levels because we still need the moves we would need in order to get around the overworld, but all the levels are open, open to us, so we don't have to do the Jiggy Wiggy challenges. But I'm still gonna play through the game and just kind of do the levels I want. Probably with the exception of, well, it would have been the first level, but I've gotten past that already. And maybe Jolly Roger Lagoon. I'll probably skip that one too, and we'll just head into a different level. I really want to go play Hailfire Peak. So when we get into the cliff tops there, I'll probably head over to Hailfire Peak and see how much of the game I can actually get through, how much of the level I can actually get through, because I'm not 100% sure how much of the, I'm not 100% sure how much of the level I can actually access with the moves that I have at the time. I'm definitely going to go around and get all the eggs. Oh, this is funny. We are, for anyone who doesn't know, also I apologize for that, that was my phone. For anyone who hasn't played this game, Humbawamba, as I was saying earlier, is the other shaman in this game that they replaced Mumbo with, and they have this big rivalry. So they have this big rivalry. So you're actually not allowed to go into her wigwam as Mumbo, which I thought was really funny. That's another really nice touch that they threw in there. It's just like, nope, you are not allowed to come in here. I don't like you. also, I really hope that the game is loud enough, because this game has fantastic music, just like the first one does, because Grant Kirkhope is awesome. He did a really good soundtrack for this game. I wish it got released on an actual disc, because I would buy it. So I would love to have something like that. It's a really good soundtrack. Alright, so we're just gonna use the warp pad to head back over to near the train station here. We're gonna get access to the train, which is pretty awesome. The train allows us to go from level to level, and then we're gonna come back out and we're gonna do this Canary Mary section here so we can get a Cheeto page. I've already done the one that's required to get the Jiggy, but we're gonna get the Cheeto page as well. But yeah, the train allows you to access levels via train stations in those levels. And you get to different areas depending, like some of the levels you can only access them through the train station, which is pretty cool. Maybe it's a Jiggy. Yeah, it's totally a Jiggy, Kazooie. Rawr! So the cool thing about this game is that there's more bosses than, you know, just Grunty. Who dares enter old King Cole's boiler? I'm Banjo! Diddy Kong Racing, that was so good. Little fun fact, Diddy Kong Racing is actually Banjo's first appearance. I think that's right. I know it was Conker's first appearance, because that wasn't until 2001. I could be wrong about Banjo, though, but I feel like it came out in the same year Banjo came out, so maybe it was really close. It's possible that it wasn't actually his first appearance. God, I have terrible aim. There we go. So yeah, because it's so hot in here, we're actually losing stuff from our air meter. But apparently every time it goes into a cutscene, it gives us our air back. Which is cool. But yeah, it's basically so hot that we're losing stuff from our air meter. And now he's just gonna be a pile of coal legs running around. I always liked that this game added more bosses in. Some of them aren't, oh shit, some of them aren't great, but for the most part, they're pretty good. I like most of them. Perhaps I'll let you use my train after all, but don't you dare hit anything. I've only just polished. Honestly. Alrighty, so we're gonna get a Jiggy from this. Also, you know, for it being so hot that we can't, you know, breathe in here, it's pretty interesting that we can walk on all this burning coal. That's quite the interesting oversight there. So yeah, now if we unlock train stations in other levels, we can just hit the go pad that was in there, and we can head to other levels, which is pretty cool. And now we're going to head into this Canary Mary thing. If I can... There we go. So basically, with Canary Mary here, you just have to mash the A button over and over again. Until you, you know, get to where you're going. And if I really have to, I'll mash properly. Or, well, I guess I am mashing properly. I'll mash the way that I mash if I really have to. But it's only the last level in the game. Well, last level in the game, I should say. That I really have trouble with the Canary Mary sections, which are only in this level and that level. But in that level, it is so ridiculous. The rubber banding is atrocious. Like, I don't know how I did it. Actually, I don't even know if I did do it when I was younger. I was going to say I have no idea how I did it when I was a kid, but I don't even think I did. It always amazes me when I have trouble with games now. Like older games when I go back to play them, because it's like I beat this when I was a kid. Like Ocarina of Time, I still get lost in the water temple. I beat that way, I guess, when I was like 5, because yeah, 98, that's when it would have come out. I beat that when I was like 5, and I have no idea how like my 5-year-old brain contemplated getting through the water temple, because I still have trouble with it today. And that's really just getting lost in stuff. When I played Master Quest for the first time, the only part I really had trouble with was in the middle spire room there, which if you've played it, you probably know what I'm talking about. But otherwise, I feel like they completely did a 180 with, with the Water Temple in Master Quest, because the entire point of Master Quest was supposed to be make everything more challenging and make it just completely new. But I feel like they actually made it easier, and I think part of that is just having access to the hookshot so early on, in comparison to when you get it in the original Ocarina of Time. Okay, so we need to go to Ordence's station thing, which I think is over here. So that we can grab the last Jiggy that is available to us right now. At least I think it's the last one that's available to us right now. I know of one that I can't get at the moment. But I think we don't have access to the other ones yet either. But I could be wrong. Brandon, I probably am wrong. Okay, so this is another new feature in Banjo-Tooie, being able to use Kazooie like a gun. So we're now going to come in here, and we have to defuse some dynamite, which I don't remember where all this is. I knew at one point because I started to learn the speed run for this game. So we're gonna see how this goes. I want to grab the ones up here first. I'm gonna get so lost trying to do this. I forgot the best route for it. Because there's usually one that I just forget about, and I just can't find it. So I guess we're going to see how it goes, if it decides to be nice and just let me go in the right direction. Because I get lost so easy in here, it may as well be a maze. That's the middle. Dun, 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 dun. Yeah! Whoa, jeez, he's right there. Yeah! Got him. Three more. Okay. Okay, we have like a minute and a half to look for this last one here. Hopefully we can find it. I actually think it's up here somewhere. I've got that one. Oh, you know what? I actually think I know where it is. I think it's... That's the entrance. Fuck, I have to find it. Goddamn. I always get so mixed up on the last one. I came from that way. Okay, I dropped... No, I didn't drop down, though. I came through here. This is what I'm talking about. I'm not gonna find it. Oh, I hear it! No, I hear it. There it is! We did it! Oh. Oh, excuse me. Jeez. Too excited. Oh, I know, my eyes are watering. Jeez. I'm so happy that I found it on the first try. I just broke into tears. Okay, I gotta find my way back up to the entrance now. Which I think is just down this way. I could actually probably just kill myself and it would be faster. It probably would be. I think we gotta come up. Back into the middle. Yeah, I think it's over this way. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Yeah, I'm super surprised I got that on the first try. And boom, got another jiggy. Okay, so we're gonna head out of this level and we're gonna head into another level now. Gonna head into Witchy World, grab a couple. Oh god, it's so disorienting being in first person. We're gonna head into Witchy World and grab a couple jiggies from there and then probably head over. I just wanna grab some moves and some notes so that we can continue on. But we'll probably grab some jiggies from there because it really doesn't matter what level we grab jiggies from. We just have to have the appropriate moves so that we can actually progress to later levels. Also, where on earth am I going? I think I need to be on... I did. It's right over here. Oops, 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 oops. I was just going to backflip right onto him. We need certain moves in order to access later levels. So, really that's all I need is just moves and notes. Everything else I can figure out. Actually, I don't know if I went over that or not. I'm not going to be doing any of the Jiggy Wiggy puzzles because this is a file I was messing around in before where I used the cheat to open in levels early because I was like, man, I really don't want to do Mayhem Temple. And then I ended up doing it anyway. I really didn't want to do that that level, so I ended up just using the codes that I didn't have to. But apparently I've done nothing in Witchy World, so that's okay. I just need to kind of mess around and grab some notes and stuff, and then we can head into the later levels. But yeah, we won't be doing any Jiggy Wiggy challenges because they're kind of already done. I'm not sure if the game actually allows you to do it or not. I'm not 100% sure. Oh, I missed. Dang it. I need those notes. And I'll probably grab a Globo so that I can turn into the cash truck so that I can get the treble clef for this level. Because treble clefs are nice. They give you quite a bit. I'm not even going to worry about that because I don't want to verse Mr. Patch. It's probably one of my least favorite bosses in the game. Mr. Patch and Lord Boo Fak Fak, I just find them really boring. Alrighty, so while we're here, we're going to get the split up pads. So this is another really cool feature in this game. The split up pad allows Banjo and Kazooie to, to actually move independent of each other, which is actually pretty cool. There's a lot of different things that you need that for, to open switches, stuff like that. This is also another really interesting thing about this level in particular. This is Madame Grunty's fortune-telling hut. You win some red feathers. Basically, you go in and you get a random outcome, whether it be getting items, getting a life, or getting feathers, or getting whatever. And if but that's not to say that bad things can't happen as well, because they can. You can get completely wrecked by her too, where she'll take all your health but one, which is always a really funny one. Alrighty, so oh, that's not the one I needed. Oh right, Bell Drill and then just normal ground pound. For some reason I thought you could do the beak barge. I think that's what it's called, the beak barge on it, but you can't. I'm gonna try and pull something off that I haven't really done in a while, so I don't know how well it's actually gonna go. But if you come like over here and you jump off this way, I think you actually have to flutter, which could... No, you don't have to flutter, because you have to use the momentum of the jump. So there we go. Oh, I slid because I did that wrong. Oh, I did that wrong, rip. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do it. I got this down when I was doing the speedrun, but basically that Jinjo right off in the corner here, over there in that corner right there. You can get to that without actually having to do the grip grab stuff. It's just kind of tricky. There I go. Okay, I'm not even going to worry about it. I keep falling. But basically, you can do a jump up onto here. And then you can just kind of jump off and flutter over to the thing, which is pretty cool. So let's grab these notes back here. Oops. Didn't really mean for that to happen. Oh, we got a question. Question thing. It's gonna randomly go through our health, and is it B that I have to press? Yeah, if we press B on the one that we want to stop on, and it randomizes. So once I find a Globo, I can't remember where they are in this level, honestly. Just to the right of us is where the wigwam is, so we can head over there and turn into the money car, so that we can get money car things. Oh god, there's so much lag. I forgot how bad it was. Ah! Excuse me. Excuse me, game. I wanted you to focus the camera behind me so I would walk straight. It decided it did not want to do that, apparently. It had better things to do than focus the camera behind me. Nope. What are you doing? It doesn't even, like, really focus it behind you. Not really. Oh, come on! Are you kidding me? This game is not as responsive as I remember, because I fluttered to get back on this platform, and it just dropped me. This camera's not as good as I remember. Like, it keeps going diagonal to me, and I don't want it to go diagonal. There we go. I don't want to go diagonal. That kind of doesn't help at all. Boom. Except I don't know if I can flip up to that. Oh, I can grab onto the rope. Cool. Okay, that works. Oh, I just have to stand on the switch, apparently. Okay. Well, then. Okay, so now we have access to this, which I'm going to use to just take over to the other side there. So you've probably already heard it. Really cool thing about the levels in this game is that the music changes depending on what you're doing. Like if you're underwater, it'll have like an aquatic kind of sound in this level in particular. There's four different zones, and I'm pretty sure pretty much each of them has their own unique sound. And in saying that, even Glitter Gulch Mine, which is the level that we were just in prior to this one, that one also has distinct music. If I can open this up, boom. That one also has distinct music for this world because, as you'll see right here, it actually connects to Glitter Gulch Mine, which you actually can't see because it doesn't really show all of it. But it actually connects to Glitter Gulch Mine, so we'll head into Glitter Gulch Mine just so you can hear that music because it's actually really cool. And also because I want to come up and do this. We're going to hit this shock pad, which is pretty much just going to allow us to get up here a little easier. And we're going to come on down here. Absolutely no burgers or fries beyond this point. No siree. Yeah, listen to that. The scrub, you turn it up a bit because it's awesome. Oh, that audio bend. Okay, enough with that. Yeah, that bend in audio is not the game's fault. That is my computer being terrible and just destroying the audio quality. Okay, so back into Witcher World here. This saucer of peril, oh sorry, the saucer of peril, not this, is currently closed. Oh, right, I've turned the power back on, so we can't do this right now anyway. Over there, there's a thing for Mumbo that allows us to turn the power back on. Just can't really do it right now because, you know, it doesn't exist because there's no power, which means we can't do the thing in there either because we don't have the power on. So we're going to head back this way. I think this is the way I want to go. That's back to the beginning. This is the way I want to go. We're going to come into the... this area here. We're going to enjoy the dive of death. The dive of death, guys. Dive of death made it into an E-rated Nintendo game. Yep, big climb. We're gonna grab that Jiggy up there, and then we're gonna jump down and get the notes that are in the pool there. And then, we're going to head into this purple one here. Which I think this is the right one. I think this is the one that takes us to the train station. It might have been the green one that does that, but we have to come in here anyway. Regardless. Yeah, this isn't the train station one. The green one's the train station. But we have to come in here either way, so it doesn't even matter. So we're going to come this way, and we're going to... free this Jinjo, first of all. Of course it didn't, why would it? Gabi! Anyone who's played the first game, you know who this is. Gabi the camel. Boom. On my way to the lava world. Yeah, in the end of the last time you see him in the first game in Click Clock Woods, he's like, yeah, I'm gonna go somewhere warm, like the lava worlds. Oh, I have no eggs, dang it. Were there eggs in your cell, Gabi? No, why would there be? There's a sign, though. Huh, well, oh, can I? No, I have to use eggs, dang it. Well, we can't do that right now. There's just a Jinjo there anyway, and that dinosaur is for a later level. But yeah. I thought I had more eggs. Oh, there's eggs over here. Perfect. Okay. Oops. Didn't mean to hit that tooth. You grab grenade eggs. Boom. There we go. So yeah, that's another different thing about this game, actually, that I didn't even think about, is that you have different egg types now instead of just blue eggs. You still have blue eggs. Don't worry. If you liked your blue eggs from the first game, you got them. But you also have fire eggs, grenade eggs, ice eggs, and click clock eggs. If that's not what they're called. They're called... my egg was just stuck in there. You also have clockwork eggs, which basically, like, shoot out a little... basically shoot out a little guy that you can take control of to get into tighter spaces. You use it in the later levels for some puzzles and stuff and to get some jiggies and whatnot. But yeah, you have different egg types, which is pretty cool. It's a nice inclusion to make the game a little fresher. I swear this is exactly copied from Donkey Kong 64 and Jungle Japes. Because I remember there being a thing exactly like this in that level that Chunky has to go through. Alrighty, let's head into the green one and open up the train station, sorry. Can't even speak. Which we need to go this way. Oh, it's over on this side. I was like, I don't remember how this works. But we just gotta come this way. Excuse me, let me up there, please. Excuse me? Oh, is there a shorter one? No? I should be able to get up there. What am I missing? There must be another grip grab thing. But it doesn't look like there is. Like that, right there, is the only one I can see. But that's just a seam, I think. Oh, wait, I can grab onto this, can I? Oh, what an idiot. Rip. Rip indeed, Tombstone. There we go. I'm just dumb. That's all that was. Just ignore that. Wasn't even paying attention. That could have gone bad. And we're gonna hit the train switch. Boom. Train activated. So now we can call the train to Witchy World. We can use it to travel back to Glitter Gulch Mine. Because that's the one that we've unlocked so far. And now we're just gonna head out of this world to Ow, rip. We're just gonna head out of this world because I don't really wanna do more with it. So I just came in to get the split up pad so we can head up to the cliff top so I go to Hailfire Peak. Cause I like that level. But I don't know how much of that we're actually be able to do without some later items, or moves, sorry, I should say. We should be okay for the most part, thinking about it. We should be alright. No, I'm actually just gonna kill myself so I can get all my health back. This ain't no Legend of Zelda. We don't only get 3 hearts, we get all the hearts. By hearts, I mean honeycombs. Alright, we came in from this way. Okay, I have to travel back to the beginning anyway. Which is fine, because I can just hit this warp pad over here. Which is nice, lets us travel around the levels, which is awesome. Makes it a little less annoying to get through levels. In Banjo-Kazooie, it was okay, because levels were fairly small. You could pretty much access every part of a level just by looking in a direction. But with this one, there's a bit of ways to travel sometimes. If you just have to quickly get back, it's a nice addition. Alrighty, so we are going to Clifftops, which means we need to head over this way and use our newfound split-up pad in order to actually accomplish some things. Because we need Banjo and Kazooie to hit different switches. Oh, there's a move I should have gotten as Banjo while we were in... it doesn't matter. While we were in Witchy World, there's a move for just Banjo for when he's by himself. It essentially gives you access to a double jump, even though it's not intended. It's just something that was found. See, Banjo has no way of actually attacking things at the moment. I might head back and grab that after I get through here and hit the switch for over there. so that I can just kind of fast travel back to that area. I'm gonna want the one for Kazooie too. Where is that one? That one's in Jolly Roger. So I'm gonna have to go into there too and pick that up. Because that one's actually a super helpful one. Being able to attack as Banjo and Kazooie when you're split up is kind of a good thing. And right here, we're gonna grab ice eggs. I should have enough. Yeah, should have enough. Boom, ice eggs. Oh! Well, okay. That happens. Now it sends us all the way back to Jinjo Village. Also awesome music, by the way. Great music. Just all this entire game. It's just so good. So, so good. I'm actually going to come over here and grab something. Since we have the grip grab ability. God, saying that like that just makes me want to play Star Fox Adventure. Belinite. Alrighty. Maybe I'll do that soon for the Play What You Own. I haven't played Star Fox and Adventures in a while, and I love that game. It's probably unpopular opinion, but it's probably my favorite, Star Fox game. Granted, in saying that, I didn't grow up with a Super Nintendo, which I actually think, thinking about it, I've also said a lot of times. I didn't grow up with a Super Nintendo, so I don't really have a lot of connection with a lot of Super Nintendo games, like, Link to the Past, or Super Metroid, or Star Fox, stuff like that. Super Mario World, even. I didn't get into a lot of series until the N64. First Zelda game I played was Ocarina of Time. First Metroid game I played was Prime, so that wasn't until the GameCube. But, yeah, that's, everyone's always like, whoa, what do you mean Ocarina of Time's your favorite Zelda game? Link to the Past is so much better. Normally I just say, leave me alone. I like Ocarina of Time. I don't care which game's better. I like that game, okay? I said that as if people are going around saying Ocarina of Time is a terrible game. What I'm saying though is like it doesn't really bother me when people make like a big deal about it, which may or may not be the right word for it. But when people make a big deal about it, it's just like, come on, guys, it's a video game. Who cares, honestly? It's not a big deal what game you like. But in saying that though, I have played Link to the Past partially at least. I've never beaten it, but I've played it partially. And it's fun. Like, I like it. It's a good game, but Ocarina of Time, has a lot going for it. I mean, it's the first Zelda game I played. The N64 was the first console that I really, really got into. I think it's probably the console that made me be like, yo, games are, like, this is the thing. This is gonna be really cool. I wanna do this. I think that like that's the first time that I really really got into games and stuff. So the N64 like has a lot going for it already. So that doesn't help much. But again, like to each their own, seriously. Like if you like Link to the Past, sweet. That's awesome. It's a good game. But like don't bash people for liking a different game, I guess is what I'm saying. Probably like what you've heard from everyone. Oh yeah, everyone has different opinions. Excuse me? What did you just say to me? Ah, dang it, 275. I didn't realize I needed that many. That's what I get for skipping out on a bunch of stuff. I mean, I basically missed like a half a level of notes, so we'll have to come back for it later. I will just, oh, okay. I'll just grab the notes that are over here, and I will, we'll go into the Hellfire Peak and probably do absolutely nothing, because there's probably, oh, no, wait, that's not the one I wanted. This is the one I wanted over here, and I should have enough for this one, hopefully. Yeah, 265. Totally. Totally have enough for this one. Wing Whack. This is the one I wanted. Boom. This is the one that allows us to attack his Kazooie, which is super helpful, honestly. Because being able to attack is a good thing. Okay, so we're going to rejoin with Banjo here. We're just going to grab these notes here. And we're going to head into Hellfire Peak and probably learn nothing because we probably can't. We probably just don't have the notes that we're going to need because Hellfire Peak's one of the later levels in the game. Like, there's so many levels that are before this one that we're just like, nope, we're going to this one first. Oh, no, there I go. Every time, I cannot get away from just falling off this stupid cliff, and it's going to put me back in Jinjo Village again. Well, at least we have the silo. Well, it's not really... Yeah, it's a silo. At least we have the silo for Clifftop now, so we can just head right back over and try not to fall off this time. I mean, that would be pretty great. That would be pretty good. Oh, wait, no, I wanted to get the Globo up there, because then we can open up the train station for Clifftops. That would be good. Alright, if we get to that, we're going to head to Hellfire Peak first, so... It's probably my favorite level in the game, too. 2 years, finally I've made it to the warmth of Lava World with a belly full of water! Yeah, I love this world. It's probably my favorite world in the entire game. So, first things first, we're gonna go over this way to the train station. Because there's a couple... Or, not the train station, sorry. We're gonna go to the, Oh, shit. Well, we're gonna go to Let's Die in Lava, apparently. That's what we're gonna do. Dang it, dude. Get out of here. Get out of here. Are you kidding me? Let me up. Thank you. That was kind of ridiculous. Oh, shut up. A dumb dragon. I can't remember his name. There's Chili Billy and the other one. I can't remember his name. This is... I think this is a Minjo. Minjos are evil Jinjos, so I'm not 100% sure. No, that is true because I have the white one already. Okay, so I need to be a Stony in order to do this, which means I need to head over this way. And yes, we have to go back into my least favorite level of the game, which is Mayhem Temple. And we have to turn into a Stony so that we can, Oh, that's not what I wanted. Ah! Beehive, get out of here. Shoot, dude. The Beehive's gonna kill me, guys. The Beehive's gonna kill me. There we go. I have to go and turn into a Stony, which means I have to go back to... Oh, that one only gives me two? This is gonna be fine, whatever. So that I can do the kickball challenge. But I can't remember which exit it's at. Where is it? Oh, that's lava. There should be a little indent in the wall somewhere that has a switch in front of it. That's gonna allow me to go back. Is it this one? It is! They made it a secret! A secret! Like, hey! You have to realize that there's a big crack in this wall that is completely obvious and definitely... Oh, that's not where I meant to go. That's obvious and definitely like where you're supposed to go, clearly. And then you have to go back to Mayhem Temple, turn into a Stony, come back through that same door. Now I'm just kind of rambling because I don't know where I even started with that. That it was a secret. It's like you can't even get access to this unless you realize that there's a big crack in the wall. Which, granted, not exactly that hard to find out. Alrighty, so now that we're Stony, we can head back over to Hailfire Peak and take part in the kickball challenge, which is normally from this level, obviously, because this is where you turn into the Stony. So they brought a concept back from the first level to throw it into a later level, which I kind of hate about games when they bring stuff back like that, but they kind of changed it up in this one. It's not exactly the same. In this one, your goal is to get as many points as you can, obviously, which makes sense. You have yellow spheres that give you points, red spheres that take away points, and then you have, like, stink bomb ones that just completely wreck everyone. Cool thing about this one, though, is that you actually have to get the least amount of points as possible. So you actually want to be getting as many of the red ones into your goal as you can and shoot those red ones into someone else's. Or sorry, those yellow ones into someone else's and keep the red ones in yours so that you get as many, the least amount of points as you can. Which is a cool way of changing it up. I'm running into my goal. Oh, good, okay. So this one's a lot better, because you can just kind of kick it into whichever one's closest to you. Whereas if you were doing, like, say the other one, you only have access to your goal. Oh shit, that's a lot of stuff, my mind. Where you only have access to your goal, which kind of sucks. In this one, you can just kind of put it anywhere. Oh, okay, he didn't go after mine, that's cool. Start getting yellow up. I think you actually have to have the least amount of points. I'm not sure if having not the most is good. I think you have to have the least in order to win. Alright, so we're opening up the second challenge here. We have to do three different rounds in order to successfully obtain our Jiggy. So this one is going to implement the red ones, which are going to decrease your score, which is a good thing, because it means you can get your points down. And those ones you would want to shoot into your... you would want to shoot into your goal in order to get your points down if you're too high. Oh! Okay, these ones I want to be putting in my goal. Because I didn't realize that you start with 50 points. I was not paying attention to that. Hey, what the... God damn it. And now you still want to end up with the least amount of points as possible. And awesome, they're all by me. But you start at 50, which I didn't even realize. That's actually kind of cool. So you want to try and get as close to zero as you can without ending up higher than other players. Oh no! No, they're gonna win! Ah, oh, they had 31, dang it. I would like to try again. That was a close one, though. And that's what I'm, how'd they end up with 31? The points decreased by 2, I think. They don't decrease by 1. How did they end up with 31? That makes no sense. See, look, they decreased by 2. 31 makes no sense. Oops. Both right into the wall. Good job, me. They're all chasing the one going for my goal. That's hilarious. That's how we got it. Okay, maybe the third one's going to implement both yellow and red. Like, I don't know what else you can do at this point, because we had one where we have to get the least amount as possible, and we had one where we start with a certain amount, and we have to decrease to get the least amount as possible. So maybe it's the same thing, but harder? Or they actually do add in yellow now. Like, well, we're gonna find out, I guess. Yeah, now they're adding in yellow. Awesome. Get out of here. Or no, because the first one had yellow, didn't it? Hey, what do you guys think you're doing? Nope, don't think so. I almost threw that into someone else's goal. No, stop throwing stuff at me. I'm still going to win. I have 0 points. I am a god. Oh, I didn't count the last one. Come on. Come on. That's funny, though. Give me my jiggy. And unfortunately, now we have to go back and... we have to go back and change out of stony form. But before I do that, I actually have to go do something so that we can just... pick up a quick jiggy for Glitter Gulch Mine, which I want to do. So we're going to head over to the prison compound. Seeing as we're a stony, we can talk to all the stone dudes, as you know, you probably figured out when we talked to that guy for the kickball challenge. This guy here actually gives us a code that we need in order to free... To free the trapped one, a star must appear before the sun rises. Another star appears, followed by two moons. So, star, sun, star, moon, moon. Okay. There's only three different combinations that you can do. So, it was star, sun, star, moon, moon. So, we just have to head back to Wumba and deactivate the stony form. Deactivate. That was a weird way of putting it. I don't think I've ever said it like that. Alrighty, so star, sun, star, moon, moon. Have to remember that. Man, it feels like we've been that stony for ages, but it was only like not even like 6 minutes. Alrighty, so what was it? Star, sun, star, moon, moon. Hey! It actually worked. Perfect. Oops, not what I want to do. I just wanted to roll. Okay, so you don't actually get the jiggy in this world. You actually get it by breaking this rock here, by using the drill bill, which you get from Glitter Gulch Mines. You can't actually do it until you have access to that. And then if we just head through here, we're going to end up back in Glitter Gulch Mine. So that's a complete shortcut to this world. And then, you know, it's going to come back in here, and it's going to be like, yo, you get a jiggy. So yeah. And now people are shouting at me, so you probably hear people in the background. Now you hear people in the background. It's like, hey, yeah, that's, you know, I tell you I'm doing things, and nope, they insist on making noise. They insist on making noise, which is fine. I mean, I understand. I'm just that popular, obviously. Everyone wants to get my attention. Oh, am I not in the right place? I'm not. No, I am. This is where I want to go. So we're going to grab this jiggy here, because this is the last one for my Mayhem Temple. Which, if I had clockwork eggs already, I could have just gotten it like that by shooting a clockwork up. But we have to do it like this, because we do not have clockwork eggs. And I can't remember if I just have to... beak barge it, or if I can... No, I just have to beak barge, that's cool. Except that's not the one I start with. I do just have to beak barge. You can also use grenade eggs, I think. There we go, that's the first one. I'm not sure which direction this goes in. I think it's... the one in front of me, but it could be the one behind me. I think it's this one. It is not. It is the one behind me. That's not what I want. They're very generous with their time limit here, honestly. Granted, it is, you know, the first level of the game, so I guess that makes sense. I can't remember if I'm still timed on getting it here. I am. Because if you don't get up to it quick enough, then it goes back up to the top and you just have to do everything all over again. Really? You're gonna make me backflip up to it. Okay, so that is all of the jiggies for that level. We're gonna head back over to, head back over to Fail Higher Peak. We're gonna head back to Hellfire Peak. Man, I failed to hire that ship. I failed to, like, yeah, to hire a hire. I failed to hire a hire. Alrighty, so we got that one. We can head back out into the level now. I actually think, like, I swear there is actually stuff around here that's just like, hey, there are things that you need to hit in order to make things happen outside, and I think that's here. Oh, God, are you kidding me? I'm not gonna be able to do this. Because that thing's just gonna keep spitting fire at me, which I just can't avoid, so... Yeah, see? What the fuck? Seriously. It's that fucker right there. Which I can't do anything about. Okay, well, I guess we're... Oh, can I break him? Just be like, yo, fuck off. Ha! Again. Suck it. Okay. Let's see what the point of this is. Probably nothing. That seems about right. was there something to the... No. Oh, right here. I was like, what am I... Like, what is the point of this? But there's a grip grab thing here. There's a honeycomb thing over there. There's just stairs up to that? Yeah, I'll go grab that after. See what's up here first. Oh, I need okay, I gotcha. I need just Banjo for that. I do want to see what's over here first, though. And I fucked it up. Well then, I'm gonna die. Rip. Death! Whoops. I didn't mean for that to happen. Alrighty, let's go hit that honeycomb switch. Let's try that. And then we'll split up and we'll switch to just Banjo so that he can hit that. Oh, this isn't a honeycomb switch, this is the pillars. Yep. Okay, so we have to head over to this side. I have to kill that guy, but I also need to switch to just Kazooie. Or sorry, I need to switch to just Banjo. So I'm going to kill this guy first. You can die, thanks. I'm going to switch over to just Banjo. I'm going to try and get up here before he comes back. And I really wish I had that move from Witchy World now, because that would have made that jump a little easier. And this is the one for the Jinjo? No, this opens a gate. And that one's for Kazooie. Okay. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go find the flight pad, which is around here somewhere. I actually think I need to I need to break something in order to get it. I actually might need, I don't have glide either. That would make this so much easier. You actually get this from this level. I probably don't have enough notes to get it, though, so it doesn't even matter. Oh, well, there's our hour with Banjo-Tooie, guys. That was fun. I really enjoyed doing that, actually. Hopefully I'll do Kazooie soon, and eventually we'll do Nuts and Bolts, but I'm not too excited for that. Thank you for stopping by, guys. So hopefully you will join me next time for the next Play What You Own. But until then, peace.